Hey, how are you? In this video, I will be using Laravel and Vue.js to pass some data from the backend to the JavaScript. This can be some kind of session data, some database data, or any value that you want your JavaScript to use. First, I'm going to start with some scaffolding. So if you want to skip straight to the coding, please check the video description for the correct time. I have a brand new installation of Laravel. And I want to use the Laravel UI package to quickly scaffold the webpack configuration and all the JavaScript files, which will save some time. So let's require that package. Composer require Laravel UI. At the time of this recording, this package is kind of deprecated in favor of Laravel JetStream. But I think you can still use that to scaffold files if you're not going to use any of the JetStream functionality. After this is installed, let's scaffold a Vue project, PHP artisan UI Vue. Now npm install and npm run dev to compile all the assets. Now finally, to watch our JavaScript for any updates, let's run npm run watch, which will automatically compile after any change that we make. Like I mentioned, this package is going to create a lot of configuration and files for us. And the one that we're going to use is the example view component. It already has some template, so let's just require it inside the welcome view. First, I'm going to add the JavaScript file at the bottom of the page. I'm using mix. And it's in the JavaScript directory called app.js. Now let's go to the content, and here I will create a div with an ID of app, which is where our Vue.js will bind. And here I will load our example component. Now let's jump to the browser and hit refresh. You can see our example component is being loaded successfully. So the first method to pass some data to the JavaScript is very simple. It involves creating an endpoint on the backend and calling this endpoint with AJAX request. So I'm opening the web.php, which is inside the routes folder. And here I want to create a new route. I'm going to call it session. And here let's have a variable called data, which is going to be a simple array, and we'll have a name of John Doe as data. Now let's return this data as JSON. So I'm using the response helper and I want to send a JSON response. I'll pass the data that we just created. So after hitting this endpoint, we're simply going to return a name, the value of John Doe. So back to our component. Let's create a data object, which is going to store our name, and let's have it empty by default. Down at the mounted hook, I'm going to make the request to the backend. So let's use Axios, and we want to make a GET request to our session endpoint. When this request is successful, we'll take the response object, and with that we have a variable called data, and inside is our name, which we're fetching from the backend. So we can directly assign this dot name to be equal to the data which we receive from this call. Finally, I'm going to import Axios from Axios. And before we see how this fails in the browser, let's correct this spelling mistake. And let's go to the template where we can render the name. Now let's head to the browser and hit refresh. You can see that we're successfully displaying the name John Doe. So this was the first method that we can use. And the other one is to directly output some data into the HTML. So let's have another data array right here. We'll have a key of name again, and this time the value will be Batman. Okay, now we'll pass this data to the HTML. Here to load this data, we just need to output it before the JavaScript file. So I'm going to scroll to the bottom. And right here, I'm going to open another script tag for inline JavaScript. I'm going to use the global window object and assign data to it. For the moment, I'm going to output this with the escaping syntax. And I'm going to use JSON encode, passing an array here, and we'll have a key of name, and the value will be the name variable which we are passing from the route file. So to get this inside our component, let's clean this up and just assign to the name variable our data from the window object. Now let's go to the browser and hit refresh, and we get an error, and of course we do, because our data is inside an array and the key that we want to use is name. So after fixing this and refreshing, we can see we're outputting Batman successfully. We can refactor this into more simple code by directly passing the data array here, and even more by using the blade JSON directive. And I'm going to remove this escape. So now back to the browser. When I hit refresh, you can see we're still outputting Batman. So if you like this second method, there's a very convenient package called Laravel Shared Data. And you can see from the documentation that this provides you with a global function which you can use in your PHP backend to pass any data to the view. And from there you can use the same method of accessing the global window object and taking any data you want inside your JavaScript. So this was all for this video. I hope some of this information was useful to you. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them below in the comments. And thank you for watching. See you next time.